Abbey National have raised the rate for money on 7 days' notice. Come on in. With Abbey National.
Technics organs with PCM sound, giving the world a new realism.
Every day I've been driving. I'm locking you away. Out of my sight. I don't have to see you again for days.
Reg, the Lawtons have invited us up for the weekend.
Psst, Reg, look at this. And Reg, just look at these prices. They're called intercity savers. Not bad, eh?
Reg, why are we going by train?
Didn't you know?
This is the age of the train.
Vickers on the phone again. Wants to know when his dresser will be ready.
McVitie's country cookies are rich and crunchy, like traditional home-baked cookies. There's hazelnut and raisin, almond and honey, cherry and coconut.
Shall I tell him Thursday?
Aye. But don't tell him which Thursday.
Try McVitie's country cookies. They're why life's slower in the country.
Top entertainment for Tuesday night on Thames. At 7:30, give us a clue, where guessing is the name of the game.
Sounds like... Is it Hitchhiker?
And at 8, a new series of Desert Connor Tonight. With special guests, comedian Gary Shandling, singer Stephanie Lawrence, and international star Tom Jones. At 9 o'clock, Rumpole of the Bailey, looking for very interesting work.
Could that be a brief? With my name on it!
Yes, Mr. Bernard just sent this round. Case of Timpson, you're leading Mrs. Erskine Brown.
Henry, you've made up my quarrel with Bernard. Come to my arms, my beamish boy.
Entertaining highlights for Tuesday night on Thames.
At 10 o'clock, it's Clive James on television. First, the news from ITN.
Thousand feared dead as Turkish earthquake flattens 50 villages. In Grenada, the Americans say all Cubans now accounted for. There were less than they first thought. Mrs. Thatcher says US had no right just to walk into Grenada. And murder suspect could kill with one blow, says karate expert.
Good evening. An earthquake has destroyed 50 villages in Turkey, leaving up to 1,000 people dead and many more homeless. Already 500 bodies have been found, most of them children. The quake was centred round the mountain town of Pazinlia. Rescue work is being hindered by freezing weather and blocked roads, and by fears of more tremors.
Witnesses saw entire buildings disappear into the ground. 50 villages were destroyed. Most people here live in single-storey mud houses, thus limiting the direct effects of collapse. But thousands are now homeless in this poor and remote region. The loss of livestock will be a particularly bitter blow. Hospitals have filled with injured survivors, and an urgent call has gone out for blood and medical supplies. It's feared that the death toll will rise, first by subsequent tremors, but more seriously by exposure. Although blankets are being distributed, the temperature is nearly freezing. Snowstorms are forecast. To avoid the effects of further tremors, people aren't being allowed back into their homes for 24 hours. But there's nothing the authorities can do about the weather.
American senators are sending a commission of inquiry to Grenada because they say they're not satisfied with President Reagan's arguments for the US-led occupation. They say he overstated the Cuban presence in the island. Pentagon officials today cut their estimate of the number of Cubans on Grenada by 350, so they're now accepting Havana's figure. It means the guerrillas fighting on against the Americans are almost certainly Grenadian, not Cuban. Another American was killed today, and they now put their total dead at 16.
In an emergency session of the Senate Intelligence Committee, both Democrat and Republican senators last night
concluded that the Reagan administration had exaggerated Cuba's role in Grenada. The senators said that evidence of Cuban activity on the island did not support the president's claim that Cuba was on the verge of occupying Grenada or turning it into a base for exporting terrorism and revolution. This morning at the Pentagon, officials considerably reduced the number of Cubans estimated to be on Grenada. Last week, they'd announced that in excess of 1,100 were there. Today, fewer than 750. The officials say that the Cubans were concentrated here in their airport compound. They add that the only serious battle of the invasion was here as US troops stormed the dormitories in which the Cubans were resisting with automatic rifles. In all, the defense sources now say 638 Cubans were taken prisoner here on the first day of the invasion. 100 more were killed or wounded. Despite US Admiral Metcalfe's claim yesterday on Grenada that 500 more Cubans fled to positions in the hills, the Pentagon officials now say there are no Cubans unaccounted for. Today, the Washington Post has revealed that despite President Reagan's claim that Caribbean islands asked him to invade Grenada only last Sunday, the Barbadian Defense Ministry was approached by a US military official, according to the paper, 10 days earlier, raising the possibility of a US invasion. Prime Minister Adams of Barbados is quoted as saying the invasion was widely debated in the Caribbean at least a week before it occurred and that Cuba knew of it. Both Cuba and the Pentagon sources now confirm that the only Cuban response on Grenada immediately before the invasion was to send a Cuban military transport plane with one colonel and five other advisers together with arms and ammunition for the airport workers to defend themselves. Pentagon film of a warehouse on Grenada has shown a stack of ammunition and weapons, but as yet no evidence of any more substantial material. It is this, coupled with the administration's continuing refusal to release secret documents it claims to have found on Grenada, that has prompted Congress and Senate here to launch a major commission of inquiry into the truth of what really happened on Grenada. John Snow, ITN, Washington.
Mrs. Thatcher said today that freeing people from communism could not justify the invasion of an independent country. It's her bluntest criticism so far of the American invasion of Grenada. She was speaking during a phone-in on a BBC World Service programme. An American caller told the Prime Minister he was shocked and dismayed at her lack of support for the invasion.
I am totally and utterly against communism and terrorism. But if you are going to pronounce a new law that wherever communism reigns against the will of the people, even though it's happened internally, there the United States shall enter, then we are going to have really terrible wars in the world. Now, to be perfectly honest, I am delighted that the people of Grenada are free. The people of Hungary would love to be free, I think, and the people of Czechoslovakia indicated that they would love to be free. But we do not pursue, NATO does not pursue her ends by force, she pursues them by persuasion.
Foreign Secretary Sir Geoffrey Howe underlined what Mrs. Thatcher said when he appeared on the ITV programme Weekend World.
What may or may not be discovered now about the presence of Cubans or Russians or anybody else on Grenada, one could discover the presence of Cubans and Russians in many other parts of the world. But if they are in those countries, independent countries, as a result of the invitations, however misguided of the governments concerned, however unwelcome their presence, that does not in itself provide a justification.
At the very least, they weren't as frank with us as one would expect one's major ally to be, were they?
That's certainly right. And they certainly didn't give us the opportunity of consultation in those last critical stages of the kind for which we'd wished.
Sir Geoffrey also said the government would give sympathetic consideration to sending British troops to Grenada as part of a Commonwealth peacekeeping force. But he said it would be better if the troops came from other countries. And he pointed out that British servicemen are already committed to peacekeeping duties elsewhere.
In Grenada, I think that there is a stronger case, if such a thing is needed, for the presence of forces from other Commonwealth countries. Really, because it's a Commonwealth country and a Commonwealth area, the Commonwealth is a natural organisation to which to turn, instead of the UN, for example.
A first cousin of Mr. Maurice Bishop, the Marxist leader of Grenada, overthrown and killed in the army coup, was among 50 Grenadians who went to church in Tooting in South London today to pray for Grenada. Terry Lloyd asked her what she thought about the American invasion.
I am pleased that they did go in when they did, because the people really needed help.
Do you believe the British should have gone in as well?
I think the British should be the ones to have gone in. But as they didn't, well, someone had to. America probably, you know, used the situation to get in when they did, but I think the people in Grenada are thankful that they did go.
The Governor General of Grenada, Sir Paul Scoon, went on Spice Island Radio, that's formerly Radio Free Grenada, to thank the United States and Caribbean countries for, as he put it, coming to Grenada's aid. He said schools and government offices will reopen tomorrow, and he announced he'll be shortly appointing an interim government of people of integrity and ability.
Let it be clearly understood that this will not be an administration of politicians. This interim administration will provide us with the necessary breathing space to enable arrangements to be made for an early return to full constitutional government by way of general elections.
America is refusing to say what's happened to the Grenadian Deputy Prime Minister Bernard Cord, who they took prisoner late last night. Cord is believed to have been a key figure in the military coup which sparked off the invasion.
The troops are searching for the Marxist hierarchy and supporters of the old government. This weeding out process is proving highly successful. Suspects do not get the chance to explain. Interrogation by the military comes later.
Revolutionaries from the People's Army.
Who identify them?
Some are identified, unidentified civilians. A lot of civilians do not want this information broken out in fear for their lives.
Back it up, gentlemen, let's go!
Go!
Their treatment complies with the Geneva Convention because they're prisoners of war. Grenada's Deputy Prime Minister Bernard Cord was handled in similar fashion. He too had been turned in by Grenadians. The man thought to have had a big hand in the coup, which led to the killing of Prime Minister Maurice Bishop, is now off the island after surrendering.
We told him three times to come out of the house. He didn't come out the first two times. The third time we said, if you don't come out of the house, we're gonna blow it up. We had a 66 millimeter rocket. He waited a few more minutes. We had people at the doors. We were getting ready to go in. Just as we were getting ready to go in, he came out.
What are we gonna do with him? I'm not going to tell you what we're going to do with him. How's that grab you? We aren't going to give him a good conduct medal, I'll tell you that right now.
The People's Revolutionary Army commander, General Hudson Austin, is still at large and may have taken hostages. Extra flights have been put on to deal with the American evacuees, but more British are leaving too. All of them for the same reason. They've simply had enough. Brent Sadler, ITN, in the Caribbean.
The SDP leader, Dr. David Owen, said today that European confidence in America has gone. Speaking in Portugal, he said many Europeans were now openly expressing anxiety about United States decision-making, and it was time to develop a clear European identity within NATO. Dr. Owen also said today's elections in Argentina, they're the first for 10 years, could herald a fresh move towards a diplomatic solution for the Falklands. Sovereignty could be transferred to an independent body, such as the United Nations. In Argentina, the polling booths have been busy, with all 18 million Argentine adults obliged to vote. The new civilian government will replace the military junta, which has ruled Argentina for 8 years. The results expected to be close between the Peronist candidate Italo Luda and the candidate of the Radical Party, Raul Alfonsin. The Lebanese Druze leader, Walid Jumblatt, has warned there could be a new civil...